Why did Turkey invade Cyprus in 1974 and create the Northern Cyprus Republic? A group of nationalist Greek Cypriots, long before the formation of Republic of Cyprus, had strong desire for enosis, unification of the island, with Greece. They argued that Cyprus is historically Greek and Cyprus as a whole belongs to Greek nation. National Organization of Cypriot Figthers, also called EOKA, was formed by nationalist Greek Cypriots and initial goal was the removal of British colonial forces and liberation of Cyprus. EOKA had carried both political and armed campaigns against British rule on the island, however, civilian Brits, Greeks and Turks were also the targets. A response to Greek attacks, British officials hired Turkish Cypriots and formed a police force as a balancing factor against EOKA. Turkish Cypriots also had formed Turkish Resistance Organization, also called TMT, against rising threats from EOKA. Fast forward, Republic of Cyprus was formed in 1960, however it did not last long. Turks and Greeks in the administration began to have disputes over the implementation of policies. Altoag, both sides tried hard to find a solution, it did not work. On the last days of 1963, Greek nationalists carried out series of attacks. Turkish mosques, schools and villages were burnt down and over 120 civilians Turkish Cypriots were killed between 21 to 30 December 1963, known as Bloody Christmas. Turkish Cypriots insisting on formation of Federal Cyprus and Greeks insisting on unification of island with Greeks led to failure of every peace attempt. Between 1964-1974, Greek nationalists attempted to unify island through eliminating of all Turkish Cypriots and any Greek Cypriot cooperating with Turks, a Cretas plan, and Turks under TMT umbrella resisted to attacks. In 1964, İsmet İnönü, PM of Turkey and war hero who fought in Turkish War of Independence in 1920s and one of the founding fathers of Turkish Turkey, sent a letter to US President J.B. Johnson saying unless intercommunal violence stops, Turkey will send troops to the island. In response, US officials wrote a very humiliating and threatening letter to Turkish administration. Altoag, the letter was humiliating, the letter sent by Turkish administration deliberately also had strong language. İsmet İnönü, highly experienced war hero, knew that Turkish intervention to island would be very costly because naval capabilities were unbelievably limited. Turks needed time to form a navy capable of amphibious warfare. The letter had two intentions. İsmet İnönü knew that Turkish navy was weak. He knew that any attempt by Turkey would be blocked by US anyway. The goal was not to intervene to the island, but to force US to intervene to the island, hoping that Greeks will retreat. But they did not in the meantime form a navy strong enough with amphibious warfare capabilities. In 1974, Cypriot National Guard, Greek, carried out a military coup d'etat and removed Makarios from power. In response, Turkey decided to take action to guarantee the security of Turkish Cypriots. Turkish invasion of the island was compliant with the Treaty of Guarantee signed by Greece, Turkey and Britain. According to treaty, in the event of a breach of the provisions of the present treaty, Greece, Turkey, and the United Kingdom undertake to consult together with respect to the representations or measures necessary to ensure observance of those provisions. Turkey had long planned for an invasion of the island, but they didn't initially have the resources for it. After so much planning, this was the perfect preface to intervene. It was both a matter of national pride and protection, but also a matter of pure geopolitics. They didn't want Greece to annex Cyprus, and they certainly didn't want Greek Cypriots to be the sole rulers of the island. Both sides committed horrible atrocities, and there have been numerous mass graves on both sides. The guilt lies upon the extremists' shoulders and anyone from either side that tolerated their existence.